हाय स्टूडेंट्स, ए वार्म वेलकम फ्रॉम टीम रईस। मैसेल्फ बग्गू मनोज, मैथ्स फैकल्टी टीम रईस। इन दिस सेशन ऑफ मैथ्स विल बी डिस्कसिंग इनइक्वालिटीज फ्रॉम चैप्टर सीक्वेंस एंड सीरीज। टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग इनइक्वालिटीज विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन मेन्स एंड एडवांस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, but in this session we'll be covering the mains part of the inequalities, right? So in inequalities I will be discussing am, gm, hm, right? But in this case we are discussing am, gm, hm of two numbers which we are calling simple means of two positive numbers. Why positive numbers? Basically you can calculate am of any numbers. Those numbers can be positive, negative, zero. You can also calculate GM of two positive numbers or two negative numbers, but GM of one positive number and one negative number cannot be calculated, right? HM also calculated for any numbers which are positive, negative, but in case of HM, zero is not involved, should not be involved, right? Why so? We'll discuss. Arithmetic mean of numbers is nothing but simple average, which is sum of numbers divided by number of numbers, that is number of terms, which is a plus b sum of terms divided by 2 is number of terms. Geometric mean of those two terms are a into b product of terms whole power 1 by number of terms, that is 1 by 2. Harmonic mean is number of terms which is 2 divided by sum of the reciprocals, which is 1 by a or 1 by b, right? So we can establish an inequality between am, GM, HM of numbers. So, but that inequality is only established if the numbers are positive, right? That we'll discuss in later part of the video, right? So, I am proving the relation between AM, GM and HM, which is A greater than or equal to G greater than or equal to H, right? As AB are positive, root AB is finite number, square root of AB is positive, root of AB. AB is positive because positive into positive, so this is a finite number. A plus B by 2 is a real number, no issues. I am subtracting A minus G, we'll be getting A plus B by 2 minus root AB, which upon calculation, which will be A plus B minus 2 root AB divided by 2. Numerator is root A minus root B whole square divided by 2. Denominator is greater than 0. Numerator is root A minus root B whole square. See, A is a positive number. Square root of positive number is positive. Square root of positive number, which is root B, also positive. Positive minus positive is real number. Positive minus positive is not positive, right? It can be positive, negative as well as zero. Root A minus root B is positive minus positive. Positive minus positive whole square, which is greater than or equal to zero. I am talking about square of a real number which is non-negative, right? So it can be equal to zero, fine. So this particular calculation is obtained from A minus G. So A minus G is greater than or equal to 0. From this I can claim A is greater than or equal to G. Okay, but I am also interested in this equality sign. So I will see where this equality sign holds or when this equality sign can be obtained. So A equal to G means A minus G is equal to 0. A minus G is equal to 0 means this part equal to 0 means this part equal to 0. Something by something is 0 means numerator should be 0, that is root A minus root B whole square equal to 0. Then we'll be getting root A equal to root B, that is A equals to B. So what I'm trying to say is AM is equal to GM only if A equals to B, right? Similarly, I'm calculating G minus H. G is geometric mean, H is harmonic mean. G is AB whole power 1 by 2. Harmonic mean is 2AB by A plus B. I am subtracting. So root AB can be taken as common. Then we will be getting A plus B after taking LCM minus 2 into from AB. I took root AB as common. The remaining term will be root AB divided by A plus B. See, A plus B is a positive term. Why? Because A and B are positive numbers. Square root of AB is also positive. A plus B minus 2 root AB, which is root a minus root b whole square, which is also greater than or equal to 0. So overall this term is greater than or equal to 0. This is g minus h. So I can claim g minus h is greater than or equal to 0. So g is greater than or equal to h. So geometric mean is greater than or equal to harmonic mean. In previous article, we proved arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean. This is inequality 1, say this is inequality 2. From these two inequalities, I can easily say AM is greater than or equal to GM is greater than or equal to HM. So, but in this inequality, I am also interested where the equal to sign is holding, right? So G equals to H means G minus H equal to 0, means this part equal to 0, means this equal to 0. Then root AB, see, I simplified this term, na? This particular part. This will be root AB into root A minus root B whole square divided by A plus B equal to 0. Numerator cannot produce 0. Denominator cannot produce 0, right? 0 can be produced by numerator. Root AB is always positive. Then 0 will be produced by this particular term. From this we can say A equals to B. So AM equal to GM or GM equal to HM or AM equal to HM. So in this inequality, we proved this inequality, right? But this equality sign is only hold if A equal to B, that is terms are equal, right? So here comes clearly A equal to G equal to H if, that is if I can write I double F, which is if and only if terms are equal, that is A equals to B. Now I am extending the concept of AM, GM, HM for n numbers. So I considered n positive quantities, that is A1, A2, so on AN. So I am calculating AM, GM as well as HM of these n particular numbers. AM is sum of numbers divided by number of terms. GM is product of terms whole power 1 by number of terms. HM is number of terms divided by sum of the reciprocals. AM, GM inequality is discussed for two positive real numbers. Now we will discuss AM, GM, HM inequality, or rather than discussing, I will try to establish relation between AM, GM, HM for n positive quantities, right? So AM is this, AM represented by sigma, that is sum of the numbers by n. This is GM, pi is product of terms, where this is A1 into A2 into A3, so on AN. The numbers considered are positive quantities, right? So let's see the proof of AM greater than or equal to GM of n natural numbers, sorry, of n positive quantities. This is graph of y equal to log x to the base e, right? So it is pretty basic. X is argument of log x to the base e. Argument should be positive. So I am taking some numbers which are in domain of this function. What is meaning of domain? The values of variable for which given expression is defined, right? So I am interested in those values of x for which log x to the base e is defined. So log x base e is only defined if x is positive. So I am taking values which are on right hand side of x-axis, right? So this is graph of y equals to, this is graph of y equal to log x to the base e, right? I am plotting some points. If x equal to x1, the corresponding y coordinate, what will y coordinate? If x is x1, y will be log x1 to the base e, log x1 to the base e. Similarly, if x is x2, y will be log x2 to the base e, and so on. I am taking n numbers which are positive. I am extending the graph of y equal to log x. Right? So this is a point, this is xn comma log xn to the base e, right? See, I try to construct a polygon. How? I will join these n points. Na? There are n points. There is x3. For x3, there will be a corresponding point. For every xn, there is a corresponding point on this particular graph. I will join those points. I will be getting a polygon, right? Which is n-sided. Right? This is not exact polygon because there are n points. So, the polygon will be like this, right? So, I try to calculate centroid of this polygon. So, centroid of any polygon, let G be centroid of polygon. What is that polygon? X1, X2, X3, Xn, X1, right? X1, X2, X3, X4, so on, Xn, X1. This is the polygon. The centroid of this polygon is a point whose coordinates are given by X1 plus X2 plus so on, Xn by n. This is X coordinate. Y coordinate is log X1 to the base E plus log X2 to the base E plus so on, log xn to the base e divided by n. So this particular point have coordinates as this. So I try to draw a perpendicular line. I try to draw a perpendicular line. Right. So that perpendicular line through G will intersect graph at a point T. So the x coordinate of T will be same because these two points are lying on same side, on same line. So the distance of these two points from y axis is same. Distance of any point from y axis is its x coordinate. X coordinate of G is this. So x coordinate of T should be same, which is x1 plus x2 plus so on xn, which I will write as sigma xi by n. It is clear, right? I is varying from 1 to n. So there is a point T. This particular point is capital T. I know x coordinate of this point, and the beauty is this point is lying on this graph, which is y equal to log x to the base a, base e. I know x coordinate, so I can easily evaluate corresponding y coordinate of this point, which will be log of x. X is this point, na? X coordinate of t is this. I'm interested in y coordinate. Y coordinate is log of x coordinate, y equal to log x to the base e, log sigma xi by n. So here comes the interesting part. Let this point be P. If I compare TP and TG, I am comparing lengths TP and GP. I am comparing TP and GP. I can clearly say TP is greater than TP is greater than GP. TP is greater than GP. What is TP? Distance of point T from x-axis. Distance of any point from x-axis is its y-coordinate. Y-coordinate of point T is this. So I can say log sigma xi by n is greater than. What is GP? GP is y-coordinate of G because I am interested in this distance. Y-coordinate of G will be, what is G? This will be x-coordinate. Y-coordinate will be log x1 to the base e plus log x2 to the base e plus so on, log xn to the base e, right? We calculated that earlier, divided by n, right? So I will write log sigma xi by n, right? log sigma xi by n is this, which is greater than this, 1 by n into c, log a plus log b plus so on log c, and base is same, log a plus log b is log ab. I can write log x1, x2, so on xn to the base e. So this is log sigma xi by n, which is greater than 1 by e is multiplied with this logarithm. So I can take 1 by n to the power of argument, which is log, base is same, and argument will be x1, x2, so on xn, 1 by n. See, base e or base e, log of something is greater than log of something, and base e is greater than 1, so inequality will remain same. That is, if log a is greater than log b with a base c, the inequality between a and b is not obvious, na? It is not always greater than, it depends on base c. If c is greater than 1, I can write same, a is greater than b, because log a to the base c, if c is greater than 1, is an increasing graph. That is, if you increase x, will get greater y value. So log a to the base c is greater than log b to the base c, and if base c in this case is greater than 1, I can write a is greater than b. If c is less than 1, that is, if c is lying in between 0 to 1, then I would write a is less than b. Then inequality of sign gets reversed, right? Sign of inequality gets reversed. In this case, base is e, which is greater than 1, then inequality sign remains same. So this is sigma xi by n, which is greater than, right side is x1, x2, so on xn whole power 1 by n. The interesting part is, this particular quantity is am, right, of what? X1, x2, x3, so on xn. This particular quantity is gm. So I can easily prove am is greater than gm. Then one would ask, sir, what about am equal to gm? See, if all the terms are equal, what will get? X1 plus x1 plus x1, so on x1 by n, which is x1. X1 into x1 into x1, so on xn, will be x1 whole power n whole power 1 by n, which is x1. We'll be getting same quantity. So am is always greater than or equal to gm, but am is equal to gm only if terms are equal. What terms? The term in which am and gm is involved, yeah, the terms which are involved in am gm. So from this graph of y equal to log x to the base e, I can prove am of n positive numbers, I am emphasizing on this, am of n positive numbers is always greater than gm of n positive numbers if am equal to gm only. Am equal to gm is only possible if terms are equal, that is, a1 equals to a2 equal to so on an. In this case, the terms are x1 to xn, right? We proved am is greater than equal to gm. I proved am of x1, x2, so on xn is greater than equal to gm of x1, x2, so on xn. Fine, which is completely right. So what about gm and hm? See, I will use this particular inequality, which is also proved for these particular numbers. How come? If x1, x2, xn are positive numbers, then 1 by x1 is also positive number, 1 by x2 is also positive number, so on 1 by xn is also positive number, na? So I am calculating am of this n numbers. The numbers are 1 by x1, 1 by x2, so on 1 by xn. Am of this n numbers is greater than or equals to gm. What is gm? Multiplication of these numbers raised to 1 by n. So this is
greater than equals to 1 divided by x1, x2, x3, so on, xn whole power 1 by n. Guys, see, this is 1 by harmonic mean, right? Harmonic mean is number of terms divided by sum of the reciprocals is greater than or equals to, this is 1 divided by, I am talking about the denominator, this is gm. So as these two numbers are positive, because we considered positive numbers, so we can easily prove g is greater than or equal to h. So a is greater than or equal to g, or g is greater than or equal to h. So a is greater than or equals to g is greater than or equal to h, right? See, this is am, this is hm. We proved am is greater than or equal to hm. So this is am gm inequality for positive real numbers. We also proved gm hm inequality, which is also holding for n positive real numbers, right? So this is am gm hm. This is the final inequality, right, which we already discussed. Let's see some tips for using AM, GM, HM inequality. So tip number one is, AM, GM, HM is only used, matlab this inequality is only used for positive terms. If numbers are not positive, then this inequality cannot be used, right? Next, equation holds, I am talking about this sign as well as this sign. Holds only if and only if the terms are equal. I am talking about the terms which are involved in calculating AM, GM, HM, that is x1, x2, x3, so on, xn. Let's say there are few terms in which x1 equals to x2 equal to x3, so on equals to xn minus 1, but which is not equals to xn. In that case, AM can't be equal to GM. So what will be the condition between AM and GM? What will be the inequality? Yeah, what will be the relation? We already proved for any positive numbers, AM is always greater than or equal to 0. What I am saying is AM is not equal to 0. In that case, AM is always greater than GM, right? So if equal to sign is not holding, then I can use greater than, right? Similarly, in case of GM greater than or equal to HM. So to hold this sign, equality sign, the terms are equal. All terms should be equal. Before claiming, the third point is, before claiming the maximum slash minimum value using AM greater than or equal to GM, check the possibility of numbers being equal. The third point is saying, I am having an expression of which maximum or minimum value should be calculated. So maximum value or minimum value can be calculated by example like x plus y is greater than or equal to 2. Let it be. I am interested in minimum value of x plus y. What I am saying, the value of x plus y is equals to 2 or is greater than 2. But I am interested in equals to 2. Sorry, I am interested in minimum value. The value of x plus y, which is minimum, is 2, right? Because it is always greater than 2, but at one particular instance, it may be 2. So to calculate, that is another example, x into y is less than or equals to 8. X into y is a number which is always, yeah, which produces the numbers which are less than or equals to 8. The maximum value that x into y can produce is 8. So I should use this symbol to write maximum, and I should use this equal to sign to write minimum. So for a particular expression or equation, to evaluate maximum or minimum value using this particular inequality, we should use the equality symbol. So then it is like point 2, equation holds, that is equality symbol only holds if terms are equal, right? Okay. So next, we are seeing inequality
which is involving weighted means. So there are n positive numbers and these are their weights, and I am considering these numbers as rational, right? So I am adding a1 q1 times a2 q2 times, so on an, I am adding qn times. A2 is q2 times plus so on, this is qn times. The denominator should be number of terms, which is this is occurring q1 times, this is occurring q2 times, this is occurring qn times. The number of terms will be q1 plus q2 plus q3 plus so on qn, which is greater than or equal to, I am using am greater than or equal to gm. This is arithmetic mean of these numbers. Geometric mean is multiplication of these numbers, whole power 1 by number of numbers. Multiplication of these numbers is like a1 should multiplied by q1, a1 should be multiplied q1 times, so a1 power q1 into a2 should be multiplied q2 number of times, a2 q2 so on an qn. This is product of terms, whole power 1 by number of terms, which is q1 plus q2 plus q3 plus so on qn. So this is typical AMGM, but every number is having a particular weight. If q1, q2, q1 so on are 1, then I will be getting typical AMGM inequality. A1 is occurring one time, A2 occurring one time, A3, AN occurs one time. Then A1 plus A2 plus so on AN by N is greater than or equals to A1 into A2 into A3 so on AN whole power 1 by N, right? So let's see this question. A1 plus A2 plus so on AN is 1. They are claiming A is greater than equal to 0. AI is greater than 0 for all I equals to 1, 2, 3, so on A1. 1, 2, 3, so on N. That is A1, A2, A3 and AN. All are positive numbers, right? So they are interested in maximum value of A1 square into A2 into A3 so on AN. So I can evaluate the maximum value using AMGM. How come AMGM? These given numbers are positive numbers and this is product of terms and required is maximum value, right? In AMGM inequality, the right side of inequality is addition, the left side is addition, the right side is product of terms. But A1 is multiplying 2 times, A1 is multiplied 2 times. So what I am doing is, I will write A1 by 2 plus A1 by 2 plus A2 plus A3 plus so on AN. I am applying AMGM on these numbers, right? Greater than equals to, product of terms is AN whole power 1 by number of terms, which is, sorry, number of terms is n plus 1, right? A1 by 2, A1 by 2, these are 2 terms and these are n minus 1 terms. So n minus 1 plus 2 is n plus 1 whole power 1 by number of terms, which is n plus 1. So the RHS is the required part, like A1 square, A2, A3, so on AN by 4 whole power 1 by n plus 1. A1 by 2 plus A1 by 2 will be A1, A2 plus A3 plus so on AN. That is, this is summation of A1 to AN, which is given as 1. So 1 by n plus 1. Here it is whole power 1 by n plus 1, right? So this will becomes n plus 1. This 4 will gets multiplied here. Greater than equals to A1 square, A2, A3, so on AN. Right, so this is an expression which can produce values which are less than or equals to this number, less than or equals to, but I am interested in maximum value. The maximum value of this particular expression should be 4 times 1 by n plus 1
होल पर एन प्लस वन. बट एज डिस्कस्ड एर्लियर आई सेड बिफोर क्लेमिंग मैक्सिमम और मिनिमम वैल्यू ऑफ ए फंक्शन और एन एक्सप्रेशन यूजिंग AMGM inequality, that is AMGM HM inequality, check the possibilities of numbers being equal, right? Why? Because you are using equal to sign. We have written the maximum value of this as this, means I am using equal to sign. So AM equal to GM is only possible if terms are equal. So check the possibility. I am checking here, right? So I will check whether the terms are equal or not. So a1 by 2 equals to a1 by 2, which is fine, which is equals to a2, which is equals to a3, so on, which is equals to an, right? So this can be true, completely fine, no such issues, because all numbers are positive. A1 can be 2a2, a1 can be 2a3, a1 can be 2an, and from this equation we'll be getting a1 equal to an, which is completely fine. So as numbers can be equal, I can claim am equal to gm. So I can use this particular symbol. So from this, I can say the maximum value of this given expression is this 4 times 1 by n plus 1 whole power n plus 1, right? So let's go to next question. So the last inequality of this session is Cauchy's cause inequality. So in this inequality, I am considering two set of numbers, right? But these numbers can be positive or negative or can be zero, right? There is no such requirement that these numbers should be positive, okay? So what it is claiming? A1 into B1 plus A2 into B2 plus so on AN into BN whole square is less than equals to A1 square plus A2 square plus AN square. That is sum of squares of this first set. This is sum of squares of this second set of numbers, right? So here it is less than or equal to, but the equality sign only holds if B1 by A1 equals to B2 by A2 equals to B3 by A3, so on equals to BN by AN, right? So we can prove this Cauchy's cause inequality, right? I am proving this Cauchy's cause inequality for three numbers. I am taking two vectors. One is U bar, which is U1 I cap plus U2 J cap plus U3 K cap. V bar is V1 I cap plus V2 J cap plus V3 K, right? We know U dot V dot product, which is mod U into mod V into cos theta, right? We know that maximum value of cos theta is less than or equals to 1. So if I compare mod U into mod V into cos theta with mod of U into mod V into 1. See, here it is cos theta whose values is less than or equals to 1, but in this expression its value is exactly 1. So cos theta is less than or equal to 1. So I can write less than or equals to, right? So U dot V mod U into mod V into cos theta is U dot V. I can write U dot V is less than or equals to mod U into mod V. U dot V is dot product of these two vectors, which is U1 V1 plus U2 V2 plus U3 V3, which is less than or equals to mod of U bar into mod of V bar. Mod of U bar is magnitude of this particular vector, which is under root U1 square plus U2 square plus U3 square into square root of V1 square plus V2 square plus V3 square, right? Upon squaring, we'll be getting U1 V1 plus U2 V2 plus U3 V3 less than or equals to U1 square plus U2 square plus U3 square multiplied by V1 square plus v2 square plus v3 square, right? So see, a1b1, a2b2, so on anb1, which is in this form, it will be whole square, right? Here it is square root, then I am squaring on, you can do squaring on both sides, right? Right side will be sum of squares of first set of numbers, which is this. This is sum of squares of second set of numbers, which is this. We are discussing about this particular sign, which is equal to. So, if u bar dot v bar equals to mod u dot mod v, means cos theta should be equals to 1, because inequality arised due to this inequality. What I am saying, I will use this equation, this equal to symbol. Then u dot v should be 0, cos theta should be 1. Cos theta should be 1. Then u dot v should be mod u into mod v. If cos theta equals to 1, this implies theta equal to 0. Theta is angle between these two vectors, u bar and v bar. If angle between two vectors is 0, then vectors will be parallel. Like this, right? So these two directions are same. If this is u bar, this is v bar, and these two are parallel, what we can claim? Ratio of their components is same, corresponding components. That is, x component of u is u1 by x component of v is v1 equals to x component of u is u2 by v2 equals to u3 by v3. Right? Is equals to u3 by v3. So, from this, I can also prove this particular condition. This particular condition, the condition for which left side expression is equals to this expression. So, this is known under Cauchy-Schwarz inequality, right? So, we'll be discussing some questions on this Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. So, question is, if 3 tan x plus 4 tan y plus 5 into tan z equals to 20, then find minimum value of tan square x plus tan square y plus tan square z, right? See, so in Cauchy-Schwarz inequality, what we observed is we need two set of numbers. One is 3, one is 4, one is 5. Another set of numbers can be taken as tan x, tan y, and tan z. The LHS of Cauchy-Schwarz inequality is multiplying these two set of numbers, that is 3 into tan x plus 4 into tan y plus 5 into tan z whole square less than equals to. Right side will be sum of squares of these two set of numbers, which is 3 square plus 4 square plus 5 square multiplied by tan square x plus tan square y plus tan square z, which is required, right? Tan square x plus tan square y plus tan square z. So, 3 tan x plus 4 tan y plus 5 tan z, value is 20, square is less than equals to 9 plus 16 plus 25. This is 25 plus 25. This will be 50 into tan square x plus tan square y plus tan square z, which is required. From this, we can easily write tan square x plus tan square y plus tan square z is greater than or equals to 400 by 50, which is 80, right? So, they are interested in minimum value. This expression can produce values which are greater than or equals to 80. So, the minimum value should be 80, right? So let's see a few more questions. So they are interested in minimum value of x square plus 9 by x square. This question can be easily solved using AMGM, right? X square is positive, 9 by x square is also positive. X square plus 9 by x square is greater than equals to by 2. Basically, this is AM of these two numbers. GM is product of these numbers multiplied whole power 1 by number of terms. So this is required number. X square plus 9 by x square, in fact this is required expression, is greater than equals to 2 into square root of 9 is 3, which will be 6. So from this inequality I can say this can produce values which are greater than or equal to 6. So before claiming minimum value, check whether terms are equal or not, right? So what I am saying is you can claim x square plus 9 by x square's minimum value is 6, lekin before it check whether terms on which AMGM is applied are equal or not. From here we will be getting x power 4 equals to 9, so x can be plus or minus 9 power 1 by 4, which is completely fine, right? How come we know terms are equal or not? Simply equate the terms and solve for variable. If x is finite, then you can say that these two can be equal, then am can be equal to gm, then I can use this symbol. So from that I can easily claim minimum value of x square plus 9 by x square as 6. Okay, let's see another question. Minimum value of x square plus 9 plus 4 by x square plus 9. So they are interested in minimum value of this expression. So this is a positive term, this is a positive term, I can use AMGM. So I am using x square plus 9 plus 4 by x square plus 9 by 2 is greater than or equals to x square plus 9 multiplied by 4 by x square plus 9. This is product of terms raised to 1 by number of terms. These two gets cancelled. From here I can claim x square plus 9 plus 4 by x square plus 9. We can write x square plus 9 plus 4 by x square plus 9 is greater than or equals to square root of 4 is 2, 2 2 is 4. But is this equality symbol holds? My question is this equal to symbol holds? If this equal to symbol holds, I can say x square plus 9 plus 4 by x square plus 9 equals to 4. That is, the minimum value of this expression is 4. But before claiming, let's check whether terms are equal or not. So I'm writing the checking part here, okay? What should I check? Whether x square plus 9 equal to 4 by x square plus 9, right? From here I can write x square plus 9 whole square equals to 4. From here we will be getting x square plus 9 equals to 2 or minus 2. X square will be minus 7 comma minus 11. X is a real number, x square can't be negative. So in this question numbers can't be equal, so AM cannot be equal to GM. So from this inequality I cannot claim x square plus 9 plus 4 by x square plus 9 can produce 4. The minimum value of this expression is not 4. So then how can we calculate the minimum value of this particular expression, right? So I am drawing a graph y equals to f of x, which is capital X plus 4 by capital X. the graph will be like this. The graph of that particular function will be like this. This is the graph, right? So this line does not touch or intersect this portion of the graph. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. This line is y equals to, we can say x, right? This line is y equal to x. This particular point will be 2. This particular point will be minus 2. See, here comes the interesting part. I need something plus 4 by something, but that something is greater than or equals to 9, because x is a real number. X square is greater than or equal to 0. So x square plus 9 is greater than or equals to 9. So here I should analyze x plus 4 by capital X, where capital X is greater than or equals to 9. Right? Where capital X is greater than or equals to 9. Here it is 2. 9 will be here. I am interested in portion of the graph of x plus 4 by x, which is on right hand side of 9. So this region. So I will be getting this graph. So, what I am saying is, this particular graph and this function are same. Same means, I can evaluate range of x plus 4 by x, where x is greater than or equals to 9. And I can say, the range of this function is same. Because I replaced small x square plus 9 with capital F of x, with capital X, sorry, right? So, if x is greater than or equals to 9, I am interested in this portion of graph. So, this portion of the graph is producing a minimum value at capital X equals to 9. As you can see, it is the minimum value, right? The points which are lying on the graph are above this particular point, let it be these points. So, the minimum is occurring at X equals to 9, which is 9 plus 4 by 9. So, as I said, terms are not equal in this case, so AM can't be equal to GM, so I cannot evaluate minimum value of this particular function using AMGM. So minimum value is not equals to 4, but what is the minimum value? The minimum value is 9 plus 4 by 9. So this should be the answer, right? So there are few questions in which AMGM, matlab, in this question you can use AMGM, but you cannot calculate maximum or minimum value of this function as terms can't be equal. It can be calculated using graph, which is 9 plus 4 by 9, right? So in these type of cases, we would discard this method and try to solve using graphs, right? Okay, so let's go to next question. F of x equals to 4x power 4 minus ax cube r1, r2, r3, r4 are roots of this equation, then find a. Right. So this is a biquadratic equation which having roots as r1, r2, r3, r4, and they are saying find the value of a, which is coefficient of x cube, right? And there is another relation which is given in the question, that is r1 by 2 plus r2 by 3, r2 by 4 plus r3 by 5 plus r4 by 8 equals to 1. This is also given. This is also given in the question. They are interested in value of a. Okay. So, r1, r2, r3, r4 are the roots. this is sum of four numbers, and the interesting part is R1, R3, R4 are all positive. It is mentioned in the question, right?
So these particular numbers are also positive. I will try to calculate AM of these numbers, which will be R1 by 2 plus R2 by 4 plus R3 by 5 plus R4 by 8 divided by 4, which is 1 by 4.
I will try to calculate GM. It will be R1 by 2 into R2 by 4 into R3 by 5 into R4 by 8 whole power 1 by 4, which is, in numerator I am getting R1 into R2 into R3 into R4.
So as R1, R2, R3, R4 are roots of this equation, R1 into R2 into R3 into R4 is product of roots of this equation. Product of roots is 5 by 4, numerator will be 5 by 4 into, the rest of numbers are 2 into 4 into 5 into 8 whole power 1 by 8. This is 5. These two gets cancelled, right? 4 into 2, 8, 8 into 4 into 8 whole power 1 by 4. We'll be getting 1 by 4, right? 2 into 4 is 4 into 4. 4, 4 times whole power 1 by 4. We'll be getting 1 by 4.
The interesting part is, this is AM of R1 by 2, R2 by 4, R3 by 5 or R4 by 8. And this is GM of R1 by 2, R2 by 4, R3 by 5, R5, R4 by 8. Same numbers. AM equal to GM. So, I can conclude terms are equal. R1 by 2 equals to R2 by 4 equal to R3 by 5. This is the second part of the question, equal to R4 by 8, right? Let it be K, right? But they're interested in value of A, which is coefficient of X cube. So from this, I can write R1 equals to 2K, R2 equals to 4K, R3 equals to 5K and R4 equals to 8K, right? So sum of the roots will be what? Sum of the roots will be A by 4, that is 2K plus 4K is 6K, 6K plus 5K is 11K, 11K plus 8K is 19K, is A by 4. How can we calculate value of K? See, R1 by 2 plus R2 by 4 plus R3 by 5 plus R4 by 5, 8 is 1. So, these are same. So, each value should be R1 by 2 equals to R2 by 4 equal to R3 by 5 equals to R4 by 8 equal to 1 by 4, right? So, the value of K is 1 by 4. 19 into 1 by 4 equals to A by 4. 4, 4 gets cancelled. From this you can calculate value of A, which is 19. So this is a beautiful question which is involved using AMGM. But in this question, it is not mentioned we should AMGM. But by seeing the positive numbers and the sum of numbers, we can get an idea of using AMGM in these particular type of questions, right? Okay. So, if x and y are real numbers such that this plus this equals to 1, then find the values of x and y, right? So, this is a positive number, this is also positive. I am using AMGM for these numbers. 16 power x square plus y plus 16 power y square plus x by 2 is greater than equals to 16 power x square plus y into 16 power y square plus x whole power 1 by 2. This is 1. We will be getting 1 by 2 is greater than equals to 16, right? 2 power 4 x square plus 4y plus 4 y square plus 4x whole power 1 by 2. This is 2 power minus 1 is greater than equals to 2 power this whole power 1 by 2. A power m whole power n is mn. We'll be getting 2x square plus 2y plus 2y square plus 2x. As powers are same and power is greater than 1, I can easily compare exponents which is of same sign. 2x square plus 2y plus 2y square plus 2x. So this is little bit different question, because in this question we started with an inequality and ended with an inequality which is involving two expressions, two variables. So what I can say is 2x square plus 2y square plus 2x plus 2y plus 1 is less than equal to 0. See, there is only one inequality but two variables are there. So try to use completing square method, that is x square plus x, I will write like this, plus y square plus y plus 1 by 4, right? So I am trying to complete square of this expression, that is x plus 1 by whole square. This is y plus 1 by 2 whole square, which is less than or equal to 0. Right, x, y are real numbers. So square of a real number is non-negative, it is greater than or equal to 0, it is greater than or equal to 0. But they are saying greater than or equal to 0 plus greater than or equal to 0 is less than or equal to 0. It is only possible if these two individual terms are 0, that is x plus 1 by 2 equal to y plus 1 by 2 equal to 0. From this we can calculate value of x as minus half and y as minus half, right? So values of x and y are minus 1 by 2 comma minus 1 by 2, right? So students, hope we had a pretty good session on mains part of the inequalities. In the coming lectures, we'll be discussing the advanced part of the same. Thank you.